and welcome to Book Hangover. My name is Marta and I like reading. This year I had a goal to read 24 books during the whole year and I kind of exceeded it a little bit. So I would like to share my experience because it's really exciting for me. So I will start with the books that I read for until I reached the goal. Which were actually 25 books and not 24. I have here my reading journal, so I will just speak a little bit so that I don't forget anything. I just want to mention all of the books and maybe say a word or two about each. So I started my year with Doris Lessing's Martha Quest. It's because I really like my name and I like books and movies where there's a character with my name. And I know that Martha and Marta, it's a bit different thing, but I usually when these books are translated to my native language, they are translated as Martha. So I decided, okay, I will just close my eyes a little bit on this and I will let it be. So it was pretty interesting. It wasn't a favorite book of mine. Then after that, I went to Christine Newman, What I Was Doing While You Were Breeding. It was pretty interesting to find out about some countries and how is it to travel with a different purpose than usually people travel. It was really nice. After that, I was packing and moving out of Switzerland, so I needed some inspiration how to declutter my stuff. And I didn't buy the original, but I bought Swedish Death Cleaning Workbook by Kelsey Zaria. And it was pretty good for me. It was enough by that time, so I really got rid of a lot of things and I wish I could do more, but it was pretty good. So. Yeah, it was not the best workbook, but it was useful. Then I had a little break and I didn't read at all, but I restarted my journey with The Phantom of the Opera by Gaston Leroux. So this was an amazing book and I was so happy I read it because I really liked that a musical, the two songs from it. I really want to be able to sing the duet Phantom of the Opera one day. So yeah, and this book really showed me how strong feelings can be, yes, and how they can ruin or save someone's life. So it's really nice. After that, I read Françoise Sagan, En Certain Sourire, because I remember from my teenagers when I read this for the first time, the quote about building memories and building, and I was not sure exactly. I remember the sense of it, but I could not remember the original quote. So I decided to find it in this Certain Sourire, and I found it because there was this man and this young woman, and he told her, so every time when you start a relationship, you have to pick either a melody or perfume or anything else what will remind you of it. And he says, because when I will be old, I will be able to revive all those memories with all the songs that I associated with women I dated. And she asked, do you have a lot of songs? And he said, no. She was angry and she said, but I think by your age, I will have the whole discotheque. So yeah, this is the one which caught me the most. And I think it's a great idea and I try to follow it, not only for people I meet, but also for some periods of my life, places where I live. And I also try to associate them with some songs. And yeah, now when I listen to them, I think, oh yeah, this is the time when I lived there or when I did this. So yeah, if you are inspired by this, it's never too late to start. After that, I wanted to rewatch the Vampire Diaries series. Because I still follow, I used to watch them, I watched all originals and I still watching the legacies, but I wasn't so much into this, so I decided anymore. So I decided maybe I should read books. So I read four of them: The Awakening, The Struggle, The Fury, Dark Reunion. So it was like one of the parts of the series, and finished it. And honestly, most of the time I was comparing it to the series, and maybe because the actors are so gorgeous, or maybe because I was really into movies, into this vampire werewolves stories back then, and I liked the series more. But it was really nice to look for those differences, to compare, and yeah, it's pretty exciting. After that, I read my favorite author, Neil Gaiman. I love all of his books, even if they're all amazing for me. They are all great. So there's just no exceptions, at least for now, because I have not read all of them yet. It's still a work in progress, and I really enjoy this progress, and I don't want to rush because it's amazing. I want just to savor it. So I read Neverwhere. It's such an adorable and cute story, and you just have to read it, because Neil Gaiman is just perfect. That's it. After that, I was looking for some inspiration for life, and many times someone recommended me The Subtle Art of Not Giving an F by Mark Manson, so I decided, okay, I'll give it a shot. I don't like non-fiction books like that. I prefer fiction, but there were some useful ideas there. For example, like if you say I want to achieve something, but you don't want to do anything for this, so maybe you don't want to achieve it, you just like the idea of being at that top of your goal, but it's just the idea and you don't want to do anything to reach it, so maybe it's just you like imagining it, not being there. Yeah, otherwise you would do something. So, and a few other thoughts, those they were pretty interesting. And then I finally got to the Sword of Truth series by Terry Goodkind. I used to watch TV show a few years ago for the first time, and I watched it like maybe three or four times after that. And I really wanted to read those books, but they were so big and I was like hesitating. I really didn't know if I will manage to read all of them. But finally I started, and there were 10 books in the series, and I managed 6. So The Wizard's First Rule, The Stone of Tears, Death of Bones, Blood of the Fold, Temple of the Winds, Soul of the Fire. And then I really decided I need to take a break, because it was a little bit too much. And I hope to finish this series next year. And at that moment, I discovered for myself BookTube. I was so excited, and everyone was recommending the Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. And I also saw it in all bookshops in my city. And I thought, okay, it's time to read it. So I read it and it was great. I'm not gonna lie, I liked it. I liked the facts, like from what I remembered from Greek mythology. I'm not saying that I'm an expert and remember everything perfectly, but from what I remembered, it was really nice to refresh it, to compare, and the ending was like something that melted my heart. I know that heart cannot melt, it can break, but this is what it did. After that, I read a book recommended to me, but not by BookTube, but by my mother. And it's Absent in the Spring by Mary Westmacott. If you don't know who is Mary Westmacott, it's just a pen name of Agatha Christie. And this is the perfect book for every single lockdown, because it shows isolation. It shows what's going on in the mind of isolated person, what conclusions can we make of this, and what happens when the person gets back out of isolation. So it was really, really great. Then I chose a very difficult topic, and I read the book Lolita by Vladimir Nabokov. And this book gave me the real book hangover. Like, I don't know how long did it last, 3-5 days? I could not start any other book because I was so overwhelmed. I had a lot of thoughts about it, really, because I was thinking a lot. Like, all, most of the time, free time I had, I was thinking about this book. And one of the most crucial thoughts for me were about love. Yes, people say that everyone deserves love. And then I thought, okay, if literally everyone deserves love, then so does this main character. On the other hand, his type of love ruins lives. So there are always exceptions. And yeah, that's it. After that, there was East of Eden by John Steinbeck. I always thought that when you meet the character, when he or she is already adult, yes, so we like judge them, we analyze them from the perspective like what they are now, yes, but when you meet them as children and you kind of see what was their life, where they come from, that they were little babies, like maybe not babies, but little children, and what happened to them when they are adults, That's a different level of connection, so it's just amazing. And the next one was... My mother recommended a few more books to me. So it was Agatha Christie, this time with her Agatha Christie name. Parker Pine Investigates. It was pretty cute, really nice idea. I'm not very into detectives, and it's not a typical detective, but it was interesting. The other book was La Riviere à l'envers by Jean Mouleva. Oh, I didn't write down the full name. It was an amazing story, and actually my mother just surprised me because she recommended me a fantasy story, and It was really nice. It was so sweet, it was so cute, and it was already autumn, and it was so nice to read it, so pleasant. Yeah, and after that, Kurt Vonnegut, Cat's Cradle, which made me think about science and how scientific discoveries, from one side, are miracles, like work hard miracles, yes, but also can be dangerous and can destroy all of us easily. And the last was Martha Oli by Sigrid Undset, because I was just in the mood to read some book about Martha again, so I did it, and it was Martha Oli, the story of betrayal. And yeah, there were a lot of thoughts by this character, by this Martha. I didn't like it so much, but I'm glad I read it. Then, so at this point, there were 25 books and I finished my challenge. But it was still time. It was only the middle of September. So I decided, okay, now it's time to get ready for Halloween. So I picked 11 books. I read 11 books, but not all of my TBR list. Most of my TBR list. So one by one. First was Mary Shelley Frankenstein. I didn't read it before. I knew, like, just in general the story, maybe from some cartoons or whatever. I really did not know how it was, and it was so amazing. This was the second book hangover, like the huge book hangover. I really cried so much during this book, and after, it was just amazing. So I would recommend it to everyone. Then it was again Neil Gaiman, my favorite Neil Gaiman, The Graveyards book. It was a cute story about this child, a special child, and about the graveyard, and it's just amazing. At the same time, I was doing the masterclass of Neil Gaiman on the web portal masterclass.com about storytelling, and yeah, he was picking some examples from the Graveyard book, so I had the chance to read it not only as a reader, but also analyze it from the perspective of the writer, so it was amazing. After that, it was Ray Bradbury, Something Wicked This Way Comes. I didn't enjoy it so much. It was really interesting, yeah, like think what you wish for. Yeah, it was nice. It was spooky. Then it was Nikolai Gogol V. I remember when I was in the university and I went to the play of V, and I was so scared that literally I was sitting in that theater watching the play and I was praying because I was so scared. And I tried to read this book, like I needed two attempts because I started like, V is, it was like explanation, what is V? And I'm like, okay, no, no, it's not for me. I don't want to know what is V. But then I started and it turned out not to be as scary as I remembered. But still, it was really, really great. Later, it was Anne Rice, Interview with the Vampire. I knew that there was the movie. I knew that there was Brad Pitt and Tom Cruise, but I didn't watch it before. So I made myself like kind of a challenge or task when I was reading, just to think who of these actors would be better for which of the character, and I guessed it. So I didn't check it in Google. So I was reading and then I thought, okay, this is definitely this and this. This is my final response. Brad Pitt must be this character and Tom Cruise must be this character, no spoilers. And then I decided, okay, this is my final offer, opinion, I will not change it. So then I checked and it turned out to be truth. So that was nice. Then I read Grady Hendrix, The Final Girl Support Group. I was hesitant about this because I didn't want to read something current. Yeah, I wanted to read some classics, but I just could not stop thinking about it because I like this Final Girl trope. It's really interesting, especially in the movies. Yeah, and I thought, okay, I will give it a try. And it was amazing. And if you check, there are many, it's one of the best books of this year. So I don't regret it. I'm glad I did it. Then it was one more book of Ukrainian author, Grigory Kvitka-Osnovyanenko. It's called Konotop Witch. I remember reading it at school. But I didn't remember at all what it is about. So, but I thought, okay, it's about a witch, so it's good for Halloween. And yeah, I read it. It was not spooky at all. It was like more about people and people's desires and mean characters, etc. But yeah, it was amazing. After that, it was R.L. Stine, Welcome to the Dead House. Cute story for children. Wilkie Collins' Haunted Hotel. Okay, I didn't like the ending. The same as for Stephen King's The Mist. I like different endings. Not like these two. That's all I can say. And Silvia Moreno-Garcia, Mexican Gothic. I read it the longest time of all of these because I started it at the beginning of October or maybe even at the end of September. And I finished it kind of before Halloween, a few days. Because I was reading, then I stopped, read something else, then I come back, read a few chapters, pages, I don't remember, then I stopped for a few days, and it was really, but then when I got to the like, second part, it was like very, very smooth, and I read it till the end. So that was everything I read for to prepare myself for Halloween. Additionally, meanwhile, I read Midnight Library by Matt Haig. I really liked it. Yeah, it made me also think about life and about regrets. Yeah, I think that was the purpose of this book. And also Ukrainian book Zahar Berkut by Ivan Franko. I'm so obsessed. I think it's so amazing. All of those books that I mentioned. So they are just genius. They are brilliant. And like my opinion about those writers that I had at school was totally wrong. It's opening my eyes. Then I also read Dune by Frank Herbert because the movie came out, everyone was reading it, and yeah, I did it too. So before I went to watch the movie, I read only like approximately half of the book. And then I thought, okay, so I will know the half of the movie, what's going on, and the rest will be a surprise for me. I don't care about so much about the spoilers if I watch the movie, so I can still read it till the end. And it turned out that when I watched the movie, that the movie ended like maybe one part before, like one chapter earlier than when I finished reading. So it was so great because I knew everything. There were no spoilers, and I was even one chapter ahead. So yeah, it was. I'm not so much into science fiction. I'm more into fantasy, but it's good. I like it. Like, it's a good experience. Yes, so it was everything in October, and then I came to November. Actually, I'm not sure about those last three because I read them from September to November, like in between of my like kind of challenges. So yeah, it's hard for me to tell because I can check it on Goodreads, but it's not so important. So in November, I always read something by Neil Gaiman. It is the month where he has his birthday. So I read Norse mythology. I knew some names from Marvel, but that was it. So it was really nice to meet those characters. And I also read short stories from M for the Magic and Trigger Warning. Many years ago, I liked short stories because you just read and you can move on. Now I prefer longer books, but I like most of them. Yes, they're really interesting because I love Neil Gaiman so unconditionally. And if I would have to pick my favorite, I think it will be October Tale from the Calendar of Tales, because the same as with the Graveyard Book, Neil Gaiman analyzed it for his masterclass. So I looked at it from two perspectives, and the best. Just the best. Nothing more. And I also read Susanna Clarke Piranesi. First of all, because I heard somewhere that Neil Gaiman likes her books. So yes, that was the first reason on his birthday. And it was also popular on BookTube at the same time. So two birds with one shot. I read Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone or the Philosopher's Stone, depending on where you're from, by John Rowling. Because I want to read all of those books again. And yeah, I'm not in a hurry. I'm not planning to do them all in once, but once in a month or two, I will read all of them. Then one more Ukrainian book by Ivan Bahrani. It's called Tiger Hunters. Oh my god, it's also amazing. It's so interesting. It's so adventurous, and I really didn't know so many facts which I found out from this book. So if any time you have a chance to read it, please do. Then it was Nathaniel Hawthorne, The Scarlet Letter. So I didn't get it so much. I think I will need some time to read it again, maybe in a year or two or whenever, because this time it wasn't a book for me. And M.L. Rio, If We Were Villains. It was also about this Dark Academia vibe. It was so popular, everyone was talking about it, and I was really curious, and it was not what I expected. I was pleasantly surprised, and I'm happy I did it. I'm happy I read it. And there was the time when December came and I decided I need to build Christmas mood. So I read The 12 Days of Dash and Lily because I watched the TV show based on the first book of this trilogy. That was kind of cute, and I decided, okay, I want to read. So Dash is nice, Lily is annoying, and I would really read a book about Sophia, the other character of the book. Then Letters from Father Christmas by Tolkien, who wrote those letters from Father Christmas to his children. And they were very nice. I could feel like some kind of tension, some kind of depression. And yeah, based on the years when it was all written, I could feel it, but still it was amazing. And it's a nice idea for all the parents. Then it was, again, Gogol, Night Before Christmas, and In Holidays by Christina Loren. So I like this type of tropes. I would prefer like more deep meaning behind this main issue. I don't want to spoil it because I didn't know and it was a surprise for me when it happened. So don't want to spoil, but I waited for like a bit deeper meaning for me, but it was nice. It was love, about love, so why to complain. And then also A Boy Called Christmas by Matt Haig, and this book was also on Netflix as a movie, so if you don't want to read it, just watch it. So, and after that I read Atomic Habits because everyone was talking about this, and I thought, okay, one more non-fiction book, I can add it to my list. And Jules Verne, Around the World in 80 Days, because it was on Goodreads, everyone has read it by me group. And the last but not the least was Jane Eyre. I used to read it when I was a teenager. I remember my cousin, she had like this little book because it was adapted for English learners. So it was shortened and with simpler language. So I remember reading it. And of course I knew the story, how it ended. I don't remember if I read it till the end or not. But there are books that everyone knows what happens. Yeah, like with Romeo and Juliet, everyone knows, even who didn't read it. Like with Anna Karenina, everyone knows how it ends. Yeah, even if you didn't read it. So the same was with Jane Eyre for me. And I was thinking, should I read it again? Like, kind of again, yeah, or not? And oh my god, how good that I was not so arrogant. And it was such a pleasure because the book is amazing. Jane Eyre is an amazing character. I really like her. And I was also thinking what I would do on her place. And yeah, most of the time I thought, yeah, I would do the same, except for one, like, I'm speaking about the crucial decisions of her life, yeah? Except for one, when I thought that, okay, if I were on her plane, like, if I had this situation, I wouldn't do the same, but I understand why she did it. So, yeah, this kind of sums up everything, what I read. I think there were some other books that I didn't put here. Oh, I've totally forgotten that a few days ago I read In Watermelon Sugar. Oh, I'm so sorry, I didn't put it in here yet. So yeah, literally it was such a quick book. And it's not the kind of books that I like reading, but I like to know what they are. So yeah, that kind of sums up my reading journey this year. So like on Goodreads, it states that I have 55 books or 54, and but in fact it's a little bit more, so it's difficult for me to count it exactly, but it's not about the amount, yeah, it's about the experience. So I really hope to stay on this pace next year. And I won't set some unbelievably high goals, but yeah, I would like to continue reading and put in some updates here because I really like to share and discuss book after book, not just with one or two sentences. So I hope that I will be able to do it here. And if you watch this and you like it or you don't, let me know, and see you in the next videos. Happy New Year. Bye-bye.